I'm going to demonstrate how we can use a spreadsheet to solve ordinary differential equations for mass balances for a plug flow reactor. So we're looking at a reaction of A plus B goes to products, gas phase reaction. I've given a rate expression, it's a Langmuir-Hensherwood type rate expression for a catalytic reaction. And the mass balances are written in terms of the molar flow rate, so FA is a molar flow rate, and the rate that A is used up is the same rate that B is used up. So two equations are almost identical. I've written now the mass balances in terms of volumetric flow rate and concentration because there's no mole change, there's no temperature change for an isothermal reactor. So there's no volumetric flow rate change. It makes the equations a little easier to solve. We certainly would not have to do it this way. We could do it instead in terms of molar flow rates and use ideal gas law to account for the volumetric flow rate change, but I want to simplify it as much as possible so we can see how to solve the differential equations in Excel. So I've indicated on the left the values of constants. We use the ideal gas law to relate the concentration inlet, CA0, in terms of the mole fraction entering and the pressure over the gas constant and temperature. Now, the approach to solve these is to step along, take small steps, and calculate the difference. The differential is a difference. And so we're going to calculate the concentration at step n plus 1 as the concentration of the previous step, plus this term that has K1, K2, K3, and K4 in it. And K1, K2, K3, and K4 are shown here. These are the Runge-Kutta terms for fourth order, and this really works quite well in Excel. One constraint is we're using a fixed step size, and because of this, if the equations were stiff, we would not be able to solve them this way. But for a large number of problems, this works quite well. So what I've done in the spreadsheet is input some information so I won't have to type it during the screencast. But let me point out a couple things. So I've listed the various parameters, and then I've listed their value on the right using a step size of 0.05 and a volume of 20. I've yet listed the units also. It's a good practice to get into to make it easier when you look at the spreadsheet at a later time. And then the output is going to be here. So when we finish the solution, the answers I've set up to appear here. And then on the right is the approach we're going to use. So at the beginning, at the inlet of the reactor where volume is zero, CA and CB are CA0 and CB0, the values we calculate here. So I put them into these cells, and then the idea is our first step, we're going to calculate a new CA based on CA0 and a new CB based on CB0. And then we're going to step along. So you notice I put down a couple steps. What I want to do now is just, and I'll stop, I'm going to do this all the way up until we get to 20. So let me pause and do that. So you can see I stop when the volume is 20 at cell 406. Now let's go back. So what I've typed in K1 is the equation. Let's go back and look at it. The equation here, so K1 for that first cell for K1 is going to be K times CA0, CB0, divided by, again, terms in terms of CA and CB0. So if you look at the equation, and notice I've named the cells, so let me go back and point out what I've done here. Each of these cells, like, the value is 2 for pressure, but notice the name is up here for pressure. And I've named all of them by selecting the two columns, going to formulas, create from selection, and then I've selected, click the left column. I won't do this again since I've already done it. If I click OK, then it named each of these cells. So it named this one CA0. And then that makes it easier in my calculation. You'll notice I have up here in the formula, I have K, KA, KB, and V0. And then S6 is the concentration of A, and T6, the concentration of B at the inlet. Well, then I've entered likewise for K2, the formula that's in the yellow area on the left, and K3 and K4. And then I can calculate concentration of A, and I'm calculating it by using the formula CaN plus 1 is CaN plus K1 plus 2K2, etc. Where when I calculate Ca1, I use Ca0, the value that I know. So I'm always calculating based on the value that I know at the beginning of the step. So here Ca is S6, Ca0 plus the K terms times the step size divided by 6. And likewise for Cb. Well, then what I've done to solve the differential equation is just copy. So can just copy this. And again, I won't do this while you're watching screens. I can copy this all the way down to the volume of 20 cubic centimeters. So let me pause and do that. And so the values for Ca and Cb in yellow, when we step through to 20 cubic centimeters, those are the values I'm interested in. Those would be the exit concentrations from the plug flow reactor. Well, in the spreadsheet, they're also calculated here. Now, of course, I can change the flow rate, and it gives me new values. It solves the differential equation. Let's go back to our original value. Or I could create a data table, and data tables are described elsewhere, to calculate these exit concentration of a bunch of flow rates. But the idea is, using Excel, we can relatively easily solve these ordinary differential equations for a plug flow reactor.